Hi guys, today we are going to discuss about machine independent code optimization. There are two optimization techniques available: machine dependent code optimization and another one is machine independent code optimization. There are two techniques available. Your given syllabus of discussion or portion is machine independent code optimization with respect to fifth unit. So what is all about machine independent code optimization? You first try to understand, we are writing a source program or we are writing, anyone wanted to communicate? No audio signal. Okay. For example, let us recap from the beginning. User is writing a program, or you may even do a project. You may do a project or a program, choice is yours, or simple program, a larger program, or a complex program. The moment you are writing a program in your high level language, the primary duty of the machine or the compiler is to analyze your program. First, it has to read and it has to understand the token level, that is word level. So that is the first step, that is called lexical analysis. So next step, it goes to syntactic analysis. The larger construct of the user program will be analyzed during this phase. Then it does larger construct of the program analysis, that is syntactic analysis. Next is semantic analysis, compatibility check, type check. There are few operations goes into semantic analysis. The next step is intermediate code generation. The given the program completely ups and down, it will be represented into different form. What is that form is three address code form. Imagine anyone, or syntactic directed translation scheme form, or quadruples form, or indirect triples form. Any one of such form is converted or brought to that form. So that is the form suitable for further machine readable format or further understanding or execution. Until then, you may be aware of it. What is that? Unless otherwise you translate the original or the English-like program into intermediate code form, machine cannot execute, machine cannot understand at all. That is the reason, with the support of compiler, it is a system software. The original program which is written in English or high-level language is translated up to intermediate language or intermediate code generation. So now we are stepping into, in between we had gone to other component, symbol table management, memory management technique. So it is different. That component is not part of your compiler core process. It is a supporting unit or supporting modules of all the core phases of the compiler. Now we are stepping into in machine independent code optimization. During the translation of high level language to intermediate language, lot of redundancy happens by the compiler itself. However, user tend to write something with redundancy also during the user level of writing coding, that also can be detected by the code optimizer. It will optimize. That's all. This is the story behind of optimization. Now let us go. What is optimization? The optimization prime role is to increase the speed of the program. That's it. Increase the speed of the program. Imagine your project, you will be doing a mini project, major project. You all are at least capable of understanding what is project by this stage. Imagine project code is much larger than the daily program which you are doing during examination or your practice. So how quickly it responds the project? Imagine So larger code segment, although you give, it executes quickly and responds back to you with write in output or with how it is happening. Some also powerful enough to get your answer quickly. If you look at optimization technique, the primary role is increasing speed of the program, number one. Secondary role is improving the performance of the resources. What are all the costly resources internally available? One is primary memory. Increase the utilization of these two resources, or we need to increase the performance of these two resources. That is the primary objective of optimization technique. Increasing the performance of the CPU and the RAM memory are the primary concern considered in the optimization. This is the very first point you need to understand. The definition of optimization is the primary responsibility of machine independent code optimization is working on intermediate code, first step. Then the ultimate objective of optimization is improving the speed of the execution, second step. Third step, primary concern of optimization is improving the performance of the resources, costlier resources like CPU and primary memory or RAM memory. That's it. So these are all the steps you need to keep remembering in your mind when you are answering for these kind of questions. Now let us step into what is optimization. Is a program transformation technique. This is also one of the transformation technique which tries to improve the code by consuming the less resource CPU and memory and deliver the high speed. So this one sentence only I have synthesized into three bulletin points. Optimization is the technique, it will reduce the number of instruction. That also you can add in. It is the main purpose of this optimization is reducing the number of intermediate codes. This is the primary purpose. So when it is working, this unit is exactly useful after the intermediate code generation. This point you should remember. After the intermediate code generation only, this optimization comes. So reducing the number of intermediate codes. That's it. So since you have done analysis of algorithm, always remember whenever the word comes into the picture, optimization, either you will be working for maximization of the problem or objective function or minimization. So the moment you are calling it as optimization, imagine it applies most of the strategies which you studied in your design and analysis of algorithm, greedy programming and dynamic programming. These are all the supportive algorithms required. When this optimization module is implemented, it is meant for improving the performance, maximizing the speed. Either you can look at maximization function. If you look at minimization function, minimizing the resources or utilization of CPU and primary memory. That's it. Next, in optimization, high-level general programming constructs are replaced by efficient low-level programming code. What is low-level programming code? Intermediate code itself, one of the low-level programming code. Assembly code itself, one of the low-level programming code. The moment you are moving towards machine architecture means it is low-level. What is machine architecture? The moment you are talking about CPU, RAM, registers, cache memory, anything you try talking about program counter, anything you are trying to work on these kind of terminologies, then that is termed as high level. What is low level language? High level language related to English like structure. This is typically, even though the person don't know computer science, they also capable enough to read your program and understand your program some extent. Program, at least they can able to read. Even a first standard kid can able to read your program perfectly. What is low level programming code is towards machine architecture if you are working. That's it. Now, code optimization process must follow three rules. Yes, fantastic. It is very nice to hear that we are improving the speed of the program and we are reducing the consumption of the resources, costlier resources like CPU memory. But there are few thumb rules we need to do. It is a kind of thing. Due to some ailment, people goes for surgery. Just because of removing the affected portion, doctors should not get removing the healthy organs also or healthy tissues also. It is like that. Yes, of course, it is a danger. Unwanted tissues or unwanted tumor need to be removed from the body. Just because of the removal of unwanted tumors or something in our body, doctor should not cause damage to the healthy tissues or healthy portion of the body. That is the primary concern. Always patients will be giving rules, thumb rules, demanding to the physicians. So it is like that. Yes, we are trying to do something better, improving the performance of the code. But certain things we should not repeat, certain things we need to take care that never that should happen. That is called the thumb rule of code optimization. Now let us look at the output code must not in any way change the meaning of the program. Semantic preservation is essential. Semantic, the meaning of the program or context of the program should not get damaged. The flow of the program should not be altered. User would have written with some intention, some logic behind of it, reasoning behind of it. User is expecting some output for the given input. User is validating certain conditions, the processing or postulates, something user is trying to do. Just because of improving the performance of the CPU and the memory, people or compiler or the routine should not affect or should not change or alter the meaning or context or semantic of the program which is written by the user. That is a very, very primary concern when anyone starts writing optimization routine code for optimization. Now you can imagine the development of new language, how much it is tough. That is why once in 5 years, people are coming out with very powerful language. Although plenty of languages, to my knowledge, I can say today in this world, more than 500 languages existing. More than 500, I mean to say. To my knowledge only, I'm not telling authentically. So imagine 500 language, although 500 language, why there are few languages only popular and famous. Every routine need to be taken care very well. That is a thumb rule. That is why only few programmings are becoming famous and popular. Next is, optimization should increase the speed of the program and it should demand lesser number of resources, any resource, register, cache or stack memory or heap memory, whatsoever may be the memory. Finally, the resources are only two, CPU and RAM. Most we can consider one more registers, that's all. So these are all the resources need to be utilized lesser. It should increase the speed of the program. That is a core objective of optimization. It should increase speed of the program. In parallel, it should reduce the number of resources like CPU, RAM, register. Next, optimization should itself be fast. First of all, that routine itself should be fast, because these are all the routine works together with the major compiler in parallel or works together. When it is working together, the overhead of the operating system or the overhead of the CPU becomes more. So the routine who is trying to write for code optimization, that logic, that code itself should be faster in execution. That is primary concern, because it is increasing the speed of yet another program, somebody's program across the globe. The moment a C compiler is released, you also will write a program. I will also write a program. A great scientist also will write a program. So for all three of us, it should improve the speed of the execution. That is a primary concern. Just because of that, that routine should not be slowed down. So that is highly challenging. It's a bit challenging, I can say. Now let us move on to the next topic of discussion. Efforts for an optimized code can be made at various levels of compiling process. There are several levels. At the beginning, user can arrange or rearrange the code. Number one, user, you and me, we ourselves, that is what analysis of algorithm, time complexity analysis you are doing. Why analysis of algorithm is famous? Always people are expecting lesser time consumption, lesser memory consumption. So that is in your hand, how clever user is writing a code. That itself, that is one step, let it be. That is always can be discussed with analysis of algorithm. The same is extended here also. After generating intermediate code, the compiler can modify the intermediate code by address calculation and improving loop efficiency. If you look at in the entire world, without loop, you and me cannot do something better, cannot perform something better, or cannot do any project without a usage of loop. So that internally, loop usage you and me cannot avoid. There is no concept much better than loop is available. So without loop, nothing is possible to achieve in most of the application. I can say 99% of the application. So internally, there is a popular loop optimization technique is available that shortly we are going to discuss. So what is majorly involved in the user's code or logic is loop. So that loop optimization can be considered. The next is three, addressing calculation. Most of the time, when you are using single dimensional array or multi-dimensional array, two-dimensional array, pointer references, most of the time address calculation is spent enormous amount of time. Simply I'm writing array. It can be 1D, 2D, 3D, 4D, n-dimensional array. That is not a botheration now. Pointers. So these are all the two concepts whomever uses internally with respect to memory, lot of address calculation is happening. That how we can optimize and perform better. So these two primary concerns, if we address, that itself shows that significant improvement we have done towards memory or machine code optimization. Address calculation, loop efficiency. Next, while producing the target code, the compiler can make use of memory hierarchy and CPU registers. So this also can be, the moment you are touching upon these two, it is called machine dependent code optimization. Now it is not the scope of your syllabus. I don't want to discuss further. So just this is, you can add or have an idea that it is part of optimization technique. That's it. So after the intermediate code generation, this already I have mentioned. So after the intermediate code generation only, code optimization is carried out. Its main focus is to reduce the number of lines of the code. You can write in this way also, or increase the speed of the execution, or reduce the performance of reduce the utilization of the resources like memory, CPU, and RAM. Most of the time in a program, maximum time spent on loop and blocks. So this is what loops only user tend to write, so that we need to reduce the number of lines in the loop. That will lead to improved execution. Let us discuss shortly how we are going to do. There are three techniques I will be discussing. Loop optimization itself, within loop optimization itself. Next, optimization technique broadly categorized into machine independent, machine dependent. The moment machine dependent, you say, I mentioned already, look at here, machine dependent is machine architecture, dependent on machine architecture, dependent on CPU, RAM, register, cache memory, program counter, these all called as machine dependent. The moment you think of these all, anything you think of regarding these all, it is called machine dependent. It is not required right now. However, have an idea, fair idea. Normally, you should understand these all. These all available in your previous curriculum and all. Register allocation, use of addressing mode, redundant load store, flow of control options, strength reduction. These all understand machine independent. Let us forget about that. Let us focus on machine dependent. This is machine independent. This is machine dependent. 1 minute. There is a zigzag happened. This is machine dependent. That's all. Semantic preserving transformation, global commons of expression evaluation, copy propagation. I'm just reading out only. Let us discuss one by one. But although I'm listing out these all, based on your syllabus only, I'll be discussing about 8 techniques in your syllabus. These are all the majorly available techniques across the globe. People, they will study whenever they are into compiler design. So there are 13 techniques I have listed out. You will be addressing or you will be learning about minimum 9 to 10 techniques out of these all. Loop unrolling, loop jamming, redundancy elimination, strength reduction, code motion or frequency reduction, constant folding or constant propagation, inter-procedural optimization, instruction scheduling, decode elimination, copy propagation, local common sub-expression elimination, and global common sub-expression evaluation. So elimination, these are all the techniques available. The very first technique is semantic preserving transformation. We should not alter the meaning of the user routine, the logic behind of the program. Never ever we should alter or transform. We need to preserve the semantic. However, we need to do some transformation or reduction. So these are all the major techniques, popular techniques available with respect to machine independent code optimization techniques. Now let us step into one by one. What is semantic preservation transformation? There are number of ways in which compiler can improve the program without changing the function, or the technical terminology is function or semantic. If you feel difficulty in this, you can write semantic, because you have semantic analysis phase itself. Semantic or the flow of the program, it computes. Anybody writes a program, any program you may compute, but compiler should not alter. But there are number of ways to improve. See, just for sake of discussion, I am doing 13. If you are really sitting and doing the research, it would go more than 25 to 40 techniques or 50 techniques for machine independent coding, code optimization itself. Longer duration, maybe more than 4 or 5 decades. Four or five decades, I'm telling, 1940s onwards, I mean to say, people are working for, a lot of research is happening. People have come out with all the beautiful ideas. Now, if you want to improve something, if you want to contribute something to the compiler, it is much more complex or challenging. All the lower level to intermediate level to higher level ideas have been proposed. So now let us move on to, as per your stipulated syllabus, we are going to discuss 8 techniques. These 8 techniques are known as semantic preservation transformation technique or function preservation transformation technique. What is that meaning? Never ever these techniques will affect the programmer's logic. In what aspect a programmer, he or she is trying to write the program, that intention, that flow, that functionality, that semantic will not be changed. However, it improves the speed of the execution. It works for machine independent code optimization. That is possible. So those are all the techniques are consolidated. Those techniques are 8. There is no exclusive semantic preservation transformation. Please understand, in your syllabus, they started with machine independent code optimization, colon. The very first topic itself, semantic preservation transmission techniques. Then they have copy pasted these all kind of technique. Then what is the meaning is, within machine independent code optimization, very first topic is semantic preservation transmission. All other topic which are all discussed suits for both of the title. Those two are major title: machine independent code optimization, semantic preservation transmission, both are major title. Definition for semantic preservation technique is what? Improving the speed of the execution or reducing the utilization of the costlier resources like CPU and primary memory or RAM without altering the functionality of the user, functions of the user, semantic of the program or flow of the program. These are all the words you can write in the examination, RRR you can write. So that is termed as semantic preservation transmission technique. Underneath, the suitable techniques are these 8: code dead code elimination, loop optimization, strength reduction, constant folding, copy propagation, common sub-expression elimination, within the two, local common sub-expression, global. Nothing to worry. What is local? You will write lot of sub-programs, routines or functions. So you, if your logic or you are focusing on each and every module of the program optimization, that is local common sub-expression elimination. If you are considering whole program as a construct, that is called global common sub-expression elimination. That's all. How much you are considering, whether a smaller function or within a single routine or to the entire programming, that makes difference. Nothing more. That operation is going to be same. Strength reduction, loop optimization, instruction scheduling, inter-procedural optimization. These are all the 8 techniques. Let us look into the very first example, hoping that you are all versatile in analysis of algorithm. You claimed that you are very good in analysis of algorithm in some of the contexts. So quick sort, perhaps you know, it uses the divide and conquer strategy. Quick sort is one of the best algorithm or fastest algorithm when it becomes the larger number of sorting. It is useful only when larger numbers are considered for sorting. Then there are 3 methods of sorting. One is you can choose a pivotal element as a first element, or you can choose a pivotal element as a last element, or you can choose a pivotal element as a median element. So these are all the 3 techniques. Ultimately, what you need to do using the quick sort, you need to arrange all the elements in the lower to higher or higher to lower. That logic suits for any algorithm. Only you need to change that less than or greater than operator. That's it. So quick sort, you know the logic. So the same quicksort pseudocode is written. How internally it is transformed? So the holistic picture you will have. So that, let us move on to that. This is a recursive function. Most of the divide and conquer algorithm is possible only with a recursive function. So M and N, M is the number of elements, N is the number of elements, M is the array to be sorted, A of M. Instead they have written only M, size of the array only they have written. Then all the supporting variable, looping variables, I, J, V, X, something they have written. Then this is the logic behind of, the core logic behind of quicksort. Then recursively it starts calling. There are 2 quicksort call. One is M, J, another one is I plus 1, comma N. So you know where the midpoint is there. Depending upon that, it will start arranging. It will start changing the pointers, altering the pointers, low and high. So accordingly, the code is written. Understand how this, it is more or less, it looks like a high level. Although it is not exactly resembling either C or C++, more or less it resembles a programming language skeleton. Now look at, this is what 3 address code generation for this program. You would have written, forget about these all commentary line, remove all the commentary line. Then all together you would have written at the max of 12 lines. Let us count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. You would have written only 12 lines. Look at 30 instructions. This is called intermediate code, 3 address code for fragment quicksort. for the entire quicksort algorithm, after the translation of intermediate code generation or execution of that phase, you will be obtaining, or internally the compiler will be obtaining, these are all the instructional set. See, first instruction there is no alteration. You will be assigning I is equal to M minus 1, J minus N, V is equal to A of N. There is no alteration in it. Then rest all goes. Let us consider this is what your three address code generation. If you look at what is common sub-expression elimination, 4 into J, I, 4 into J. So these two can be replaced by a single evaluation instead of double evaluation. So that is what they mean to say, three address code common sub-expression evaluation. Look at here. One small instruction if you consider here, if you consider this statement, x is equal to a of I. Hope so you can see my pointer. X is equal to a of I, a of j equal to x. Here I will write down x is equal to a of I. This is what in the three address code translation translated in terms of this. How it is translating, you can imagine. This is 4 into I, not I, 1, 4 into I. Similarly, A of J is equal to X. This high level code or high level instruction is translated into this intermediate code instruction. Operations. Finally, every statement is translated into long sequence of three address code, especially array. Array, one small statement is converted into two different statements with respect to intermediate code generation or three address code generation. Hope so you would be understanding what I mean to say. This is temporary variable. These all we have discussed in the fourth unit. Fourth unit is fully meant for intermediate code generation. If you couldn't recognize, you need to recap fourth unit. All the videos are uploaded in my YouTube channel. You can refer or you can learn from the textbook also. Now, in order to carry forward with all the eight addressed transformation technique, these transformation technique, we need to do a flow graph. That flow graph is not included in your syllabus. Sad part. Normally, flow graph construction would be half of your unit. It is missing. So now I will be addressing about it. What is flow graph is, we need to convert this intermediate code generation of 30 lines. It's a kind of sequential lines. Never it should be sequential. It should be converted into graphical or flow graph. What is a flow graph is, the entire sequence of statements are converted into chunks of information or blocks of information. We need to translate the sequential representation into several blocks. We need to interconnect all the blocks. Among the blocks, we need to choose the leader block and the child block. Only then optimization is possible. Local optimization, global optimization. Within the block, if you are doing that is local optimization, across the blocks, entire flow graph, you are considering the sequence one after another of the block, then if you are doing optimization, that is global optimization. That is possible and achieved. Mainly, if you consider after the three address code translation, you will be having, look at here, one go to, here one go to, here one go to, when here one go to, especially whenever go to comes, to whom it needs to go and when it is should come out of the logic, that becomes one block. Most of the time, the blocks are decided by go to, one of the thumb rule for block formation that I wanted to give indirectly. Now let us see these are the notes or significance of block. You will be having leaders and loops. You need to put it in one block. Leaders based on go to and loops, it is possible to convert it into block. Look at here. the entire code, these are all the common initialization happens before stepping into the loop. All the common initialization before stepping into the loop constitutes one block. Then the entire loop, look at this, go to self loop. What is the meaning is, whenever self loop comes, there is a for loop or while loop. There is a loop repeats again and again. That is called block 2. There is yet another loop. This repeats again and again. That is another loop. Then there is a if condition. Branching happens. If it becomes true one side, if it becomes false one side, if it becomes true, it again the entire process executes. That means there may be two loop. After the two loop, there may be body of instructions. After that instruction, the loop need to continue. If it becomes false, it does some steps of execution or takes some decision. It exits from the execution or the flow of program. Completely the program will terminate. So depending upon our logic, more or less I can say your flowchart only. It will take the form of your flowchart. How the or what is the logic you use it for flowchart, more or less it will be of that only. Nothing to worry of too much. So flowchart, all the initialization we are doing before then. But here we don't use different geometrical shapes like looping one shape, start one shape, something you will do different shapes. No such shapes, only blocks. That is only difference. But the internal, the core way of doing things imitates or equivalent to more or less your flowchart. You must use only shapes should use. You should use always only the rectangular structure. No more shapes, no other options you are permitted to use. Now let us move on to the first topic of discussion, common sub-expression elimination. If you look at common sub-expression elimination, how it is doing, unfortunately I may not able to mark, no pointer is supported here. T6 equal to 4 into I, X is equal to A of T6, T7 equal to 4 into J, T8 equal to 4 into J. Look at here, you yourself can able to identify through your common sense. T6 equal to 4 into I, T7 equal to 4 into I. Two times it is repeating. Could you able to notice what I mean to say? Why to use 4 times? Similarly, look at here, T8 equal to 4 into J, T10 equal to 4 into J. Why two times it is doing? Because based on the given instruction, straightforward technique it applies and it converts your high level programming into 3 address code representation. There is no other thinking process goes inside. So by the time this happens, then these all need to be altered. Look at here, all the T7 will be or need to be represented by T6. See, look at A of T7 is represented by A of T6. Similarly, A10, all the T10 will be thrown away. Then subsequently, all the T10 will be replaced by T8. Look at here, A of T8. That's all. Nothing more it is doing. So this is called common sub-expressions. Whichever is of common value, common block, within the block it is happening. Then there is no increment. You can't argue, madam, I is here, so this I may be different value, this I may be different value. Not at all. The loop comes with the same value inside and it does one time, then it repeats. So this is called local common sub-expression elimination. Similarly, there are some sub-expressions across the flow graph, entire flow graph, there are possibilities, there are circumstances will lead to this kind of redundant sub-expression. In those situations, you need to do global common sub-expression elimination. I don't teach that. For that, one more example I need to bring, that's all. But the concept is going to become same. So this is local sub-expression. What is the meaning? Local is within the block only you will be thinking for elimination of common sub-expression. Across the blocks or for the entire flow graph, you will be considering this kind of common sub-expression elimination. That is global common. That's all. Now let us quickly go forward. Copy propagation. Look at here, copy propagation. A is equal to D plus E, B is equal to D plus E, C is equal to D plus E. So these are all three circumstances it is necessitated to use same kind of expression. Why to do this kind of expression? Why can't you do D plus E one time and you can store it in the temporary variable? That temporary variable, why can't you use in all the flow? So you need to move. Come no, C is equal to D plus E, this branch, this branch, whatever may be the branch, you can avoid one more time of D plus E after the flow control, after the flow arrives here, you can avoid D plus E one more time. So you can think of replacing, or compiler or the code think of replacing D plus E, how many times it can be avoided instead of three times computing, so the computational cost is more. So that will lead to poor performance or slow in execution. So you may need to replace that with the temporary variable. This is called common sub-expression evaluation or copy propagation. Copies introduced, the copies introduced during common sub-expression evaluation is called copy propagation. That's all. So now another copy we are taking. A is equal to T, B is equal to T, that T is brought to here. Next, dead code elimination. What is dead code elimination? Is code that are not reachable, code that is, or code that are not reachable or unreachable. Not taking part in the program based on the flow of execution or based on the logic, that is called dead code, useless code. Let us look into one example. Consider through this example, you can easily, you perhaps you can understand. Int global void f, there is a function f, let us write fun, there is a function f. Within that function, what you are doing, int I is equal to 1, global equal to 1, global equal to return, immediately it returns. Once it returns, there is no scope, no use for this fellow. Sometimes maybe first year students, they may be writing like this, or unconsciously you may be writing, you may think that it will be useful for later modification, then you may retain useless codes, or sometime you will write such kind of code. So that need to be avoided by this routine. Intermediate code generator need to throw these kind of unnecessary codes because it is a penalty. It occupies some memory, it occupies CPU's time or compilation time for initialization and references, reference count, so many cumbersome process. You would have noticed how much cumbersome routines we discussed so far now in the compiler design. So this need to be thrown away. This is the best example you can write even for your examination. This is called dead code elimination technique. Let us move on to the next code. Next is fun. I need to change here also, no? So this is the main route. Now, below is the code after the dead code elimination. Look at here. Unwanted information, whatever is available, everything we are eliminating. See, what is dead code? One more dead code. Look at here. I is equal to 1, global equal to 1. Since the variable is same, global equal to 2. Finally, while returning what is reflected, global equal to 2 only reflected. So compilation time, these all need to be analyzed. What value finally need to be given to the global? Execution time only, that is eliminated. Please understand, whatever we are doing, this is subjected for the execution, not for compilation. So the very best, I was talking about only this. So this also dead store. No more it is used. The moment you modify global by 2, this global 1 will become useless. That code you can throw. So that 3 address code, you may be doing 3 to 4 3 address code. Those are not required. You can eliminate. So these are all the ways. See, into global here also, into global. So this is the best example for dead code elimination. Constant folding. So for academic point of view, I'm discussing this all. If really if you want to work, there are a lot of challenging examples are there. Now, what is constant folding? What is constant folding is, look at here, return 3 plus 5. So this during the compilation time itself need to be evaluated. It needs to be converted during the execution. Three address code need to be generated not for return. Three address code need to be generated for here. For this code, not for this code. So this is the way it improves the way of execution. This is R language written. For example, consider the R language statement. 1 minute. This is R language. This is C language. I need to change. This is C language. Now let us consider the R language. 320 into 200 into 32. During the compilation process itself, it needs to be evaluated and it needs to be replaced I by this value. Now three address code is generated for this only, not for the above. Above it should not generate. Compiler should generate for this. This is called constant folding. This is one of the semantic preservation transformation technique or optimization technique. Next, strength reduction. This is only two topic. There is no more confusion, no more discussion. What is strength reduction is whenever it is possible to replace multiplication by addition. The cost of multiplying two numbers is more than cost of doing addition. Or the speed also you can say. Cost means what? A speed only. Nobody will pay to the computer. Whenever it is possible to replace, exponentiation by multiplication is advisable, is appreciating. This is called strength reduction. Let us see one example. Look at here. I into 3. How this can be replaced? D into I into 3. So this how we can rewrite in terms of addition. So instead of this, you are replacing this code internally, code optimization time. Even you yourself need to write such kind of program. These are all appreciated during your coding contest or something, during your interview. D is equal to 0, D is equal to D plus 3. Instead of this, if you replace this construct, this is best example for code reduction. If in your examination, if you can't able to write, just write. For example, A is equal to A into 3. If anyone in C programming writing, let us imagine, you are writing such code. What internally will happen is, after what it will happen is, A is equal to A plus A plus A. This is the code optimization technique. This is optimized. What is optimized technique used here? Strength reduction. If you feel difficulty in using this example in your exam, use this. Enough people need to give you mark. That's all. So let us consider one example. After be the title. So internally compiler optimization technique should replace A is equal to A into 3 by A is equal to A plus A plus A. This is called strength reduction. Next, loop optimization. So we exceeded the time. With this loop optimization alone, I will stop today. Then rest all we can recap. That will take only 5-10 minutes later on. Look at here, it is very pretty much easier. Loop optimization is the process of increasing the speed and reducing the overhead associated with loop. This is the concentration we are going to look at only when for loop. Number one, frequency reduction or code motion. What is that is? Look at here, frequency reduction and code motion. Sin x divided by cos x is common. I1 value only will be always altered. So why can't you move that sin x cos x before the loop? T is equal to sin x divided by cos x. While this, the T is repeated. This is called strength reduction. Hope so you can understand what I mean to speak here. Look at here. This is what? Think little bit deeper. X and X. Common, some value is repeating again and again. Plus I, in this entire statement, which is modifying factor, constantly changing parameter is only I. This is the only variable constantly changing. So why can't you move this to outside? It is a costlier function. All the overhead will happen, internal built-in function. So it will start occupying stack memory for every function call. A lot of activation records will be created. So what you can do is, rather you can compute only once, that you can put it in one of the variable, your own declared variable. If you write your own declared variable, if not, a compiler optimization technique will move outside of the loop, before the loop. That temporary variable will be involved here, t plus I. So this is what loop, frequency reduction or code motion. Next is loop unrolling. Now we are going for loop unrolling. What is the meaning of loop unrolling? Look at here, for I is equal to 1 to 0, I is less than 5. If you want to print CSC, So instead of just this logic can be understood by the code, optimization technique. So it needs to replace before. It is a costly affair. What is a costly affair? Your purpose is to print this CSC only five times, less than five times or five times. Imagine what is the overhead involved here. Every time it needs to, one time it, the initialization, every time it needs to verify this conditionality check, every time it needs to increment. So instead of printing five times, how many executions are happening is here 5, here 6 times, because lost failure condition, 6 times, this also 6 times, this also 1 time. So 1 plus 6 plus 6, 12 plus 1, 13, 13 plus 5, 18 times it will execute. 18 times of execution, 18 computations, 18 number of computations are involved. Your 18 computations are involved. That cleverly, what can be done? Can be replaced by this 5. This is called loop unrolling. Next is loop jamming. What is this? Look at here, for int a is equal to I plus 1. Next, to once again, you are opening one more loop. B is equal to I plus 10. How you can reduce? See, there are two loops. Subsequently, you are using. Both of the loops are executed with the same index values, 0 and less than 5. Why can't you combine together, jam together? So you can retain the for loop, and both of the body of the code or body of the looping can be combined together, and the optimization can be carried out. There are two more optimization techniques, instruction scheduling, and one more is inter-procedural optimization. So that let us discuss in the subsequent sessions.